All right, welcome to Crazy Battle Circuit Real Bout Garu Dantetsu 2021. Matches will be best 2 out of 3 for the early rounds, and then switch to best 3 out of 5 for the final matches for winners, losers in the combined bracket. I'm Ikigai. Make sure to do your matches as you are called by the tournament organizer, Crazy Lee. Yeah, so Real Bout 1 is a pretty interesting game. A lot of infinites in this game. 3 lanes instead of 2, like a lot of other ones. What else? Kim's pretty good, but he's almost always that way. So first up, we have Stone Bout. Stone Bout versus Camion or Toro. So I've seen the Stone Bout before. I've seen his Yamazaki play. Stone Bout has a phenomenal Yamazaki. I remember, I think I played him in 2, and he was just doing crazy, like, cross-up combos, and he really has mastery of that character, and I'm looking forward to seeing his play in this tournament. Still waiting for them to get into game, of course, though. Yeah, I'm not sure who Toro plays in this game. It's probably Kim or Andy, I guess. Someone simple over with a good sweep, probably. But I think Stonebound is probably going to play Yamazaki, but he could play anyone, as far as I know. Yeah, so right now they're pinging Toro in the lobby chat. All right, let's just testing to see how it sounds. Seems like my audio is all right. So yeah, we're still waiting on Toro and Stonebout. Toro's not responding. I wonder what's keeping him busy. Well, Yamazaki is a very interesting character. I don't like that he only has 2 snake arms in this game, I think. He only has 2 directions he can shoot it. And the way he chooses to shoot the other direction is really weird. He, like, you aim it towards the up forward. So, I'm not a fan. And he kind of has almost a backwards knife input. But it's not that hard. The only thing that's hard about Yamazaki in this game is probably his 360. Maybe it's hard. I don't know. I have trouble with it personally. Yeah. Another thing about this game, about the other ones, is that it's got ring outs. Like in the elevator stage and the one underwater. Yeah, all right, so it seems like we're going to skip to the next match. And if he doesn't respond at the end of round one, he'll be the queue. All right. So yeah, real about Fiddle Fury, and there's Geese in this game. He's got Deadly Rave. Oh, I'm playing. All right, I got my challenge. Sorry, that took a while. All right. Gonna have a tough time there, buddy. Not a good matchup for you. Pretty laggy. So now we got Stonebout versus Toro. And this game is playing Geese, obviously, and that was a crazy combo. Out of bounds. Alright, so we're playing Kim, getting comboed. Yeah. Geese is really good at doing ring outs in this game, as you can see. Oh, is it first to three? I think it might be just be first to two, I don't remember. Alright, so we'll see what this Kim can do against this Geese. Got flash kick, Hangetsu. Dive kick, but hard to apply those tools against this pressure. Got fireballs, super bacon. Wonder if he has all the fairies in this game. Out against the wall. Pressure. Looking for a ring out. He's gonna get it with this huge deadly rave combo. There we go. He gets it. Deadly rave. Nice. And the air C. What a deadly character. Oh, into the launch? The fake out? He's styling up. Where's he gonna go now? I guess hit by the Hangetsu. Sweet. Blocks Hangetsu. We're punished, we're jumping. Trying to get in. Oh, gets a low combo into the Raging Storm. Nice. Definitely some mastery of this game. So much stage control with these large buttons. Did the mid parry, but got hit by the sweep. Does a low confirm. That was so many lows. So many crouching shorts. And a raging storm. Seems like with one or two combos, Stonebout's winning these matches. Gets hit by the sweep. And the parry. Here's Shifukan. Jaken. Oh, the cross-up. That was cool. Cross-up into Raging Storm. It looks like a cross-up. I couldn't tell. And with that, Snowbow takes it. 3-0. Over Toro. Oh, wow. That was some crazy geese. I wanted to see some Yamazaki from him, but I guess geese is probably a lot better in this game, so that's probably who he plays. So our next match will be Hawkstorm versus Razor 28. Hawkstorm, first school player, seen him many times. So same with Razor 28. I don't know who Hawkstorm plays in this game though. All right, we're loading into our match. All right, F3 so spectators can watch. There we go. All right. My versus Billy. Alright. Billy's got some really interesting zoning in this game. Pretty good. He's got some good stuff. I haven't seen that much mine. He definitely has good tools, usually. Good fireball. Alright, so... good confirm. In the fireball. Blocks the special. Gets hit by the chokes. Looking for a confirm. Oh. Raw super. Gets blocked. Almost ring out. And there we go. Lutan has the meter to work with. There's the upper special. More zoning. Gets hit by the air-to-air. More good pokes, more zoning. She's got meter now. Jumping. Blocks the fireball. And blocks the special. Playing really patient, but losing ground. There you go. Ring out. Hawksnarf is doing a really good job at pressuring and creating space. Going into the different lane. Looking for a confirm. Good anti-air. But just gets plunged attack. In the corner, Deadly situation, we've seen it before. Mai has the meter. Keep the block string. Ah, and that's a lot of chip damage. Is it gonna ring him out? Not quite. Gets into a different lane. Trying to find a new place to work with. But it does not work. Fireball knocks him into that boat. Going to Brazil. See ya. Alright. Jump in. Locks the special. Tries to get confirmed. Good grab punish. Locks the special. In the corner though. Huge, heavy block string. A little bit of chip damage on that as well. Has the meter. Air to air. Good strength. Oh, it does the super. Locks the chip. Back to zoning. Really not finding a good combo opportunity. Usually just relying on pokes. He has the super. Could do a lot. Finds the way to reversal with it. Wow. That super does so much. Trying to find his way around the stage, but ends up taking damage. He had the help. But he tried to, but he lost with it. Trying to find positioning. Very precarious. Mai is always a good character in Fatal Fury. Pretty alright character. And our next match will be Sprite and Bananas versus Warlock 360. Pretty sure we've seen these names here around. Yeah, so it looks like right now we're just waiting for response from... Alright, they're in. Alright, Terry Bogard versus Kim Kafwan. Straight into the action. Terry Bogard throws fireball. And Kim does low pressure. Looking for confirm. Dive kick. Sweep. Flash kick. Hangetsu. Flash kick. He's got special moves. Kind of like the SNK guy. But instead of Sonic Boom, he's got Dive Kick and Hangetsu. Ooh, knock into knockdown. Ooh, Flash Kick, but a whiff. Not the second time, though. Good pressure. Step Kick. Wow. Very good pressure. So he gets to use a Step Kick in this game. That's pretty cool. Alright. Flashkick is blocked. Finds the punish. Didn't find their punish in turn though, but gets a low confirm. Switch up in, but gets reversal, rising taco. Flashkick. And confirm. Good combo. Has him in the corner. Flashkick. Has the meter. What's gonna happen now? Dive kick. Gets hit by the super. Stand the step kick pressure. Oh, low health on both. And he hit to take the match. This one right here. Ah, flash kick takes it. So close. Right. Back in the action. Terry doing flip kicks. Oh, tries to do the loaf confirmed, but the pitch is too far away to do the flash kick. Needs to find the alternative combo with Angetsu probably. Oh, nice reversal flash kick. That was awesome. Right, straight back. Do it. Terry reversal. Dive kick. Reversal rising tackle. Back and forth. Lots of just discussion with battle. And of course, Terry beats him with the power geyser. The max version of it. Looking for him. And rocket shoot. Dive kick. Sweep. The reversal. Even life. Both characters just chipping away at each other, finding opportunities. Good air to air. Looks for the flash kick, punish opportunity, but very close. Does not unfortunately find it. Both players having very good defense. Ooh, gets cut out by the string. Very good confirm. And Terry only finding awkward punishes on a lot of his tools. Warlock 360 takes it. All around. Both players have full meter. Oh. Blocks the flash kick, but unable to find a punish. Good confirm. Blocking the fireball. Wing step kick. Flash kick. Oh. Against the wall. Looking for opportunity. It's a sweep. That might be it. Alright. Good confirm. I just got the meter. Against the wall. And that's a punish. Terry Bogard takes it. Even game. Final game of the set. Terry versus Kim. Pretty basic matchup. Pretty, fireballs and uppercuts. Upper kicks, I should say. And starting off getting hit by the pressure. Finds a punish for the ducking high. Lots of sweep and reversal, rising tackle. Throws out a fireball. Round way. Overhead. Those are hard to block. Ah, the dive kick super. Yeah, Kim seems like the guy to play in this game. But I guess that's just the way it is with every Fatal Fury. The sweep. Blocks the rising tackle. Oh. Doesn't matter if you block the confirm. Second one's gonna hit. Ah. Blocks it again. Dropping combo. But making up for it with neutral, but gets it by the power geyser. Round wave. Back shoot. Dive kick. Ah, wow. That was such a robbery. What a broken character. Wow. It just always hits. Hence, Kim always such good supers. That always like win trades. It's such a brutal character. Just watching. Oh, there's your health. And it's gone. That's Kim. So we're currently on the in-between. Looking like we're going to have Stonebout versus Thwack. And again, remember to do first to two. Yeah, I think someone put a first to three earlier. I might have even commentated it too. The third match that was just not part of the tournament. And I think they're in the game. We'll see if. Yep. Oh, Stonebout's playing ducking now. Yeah. So F3 is okay. Sure. We'll see if he sticks with it. Probably just a button test. No. He sticks with it. Duck King. Interesting choice from Stonebat. Duck King is traditionally lower tier, I think, in Fatal Fury games. I don't know if that applies to this one, but it's definitely not good. Special. And Franco Flash, being an interesting character. I realized that when I played against him, I knew a lot less about him than I thought I did. But I don't think I played as good as Franco Bash. But ducking is just making him, you know, look like just another Franco Bash. Or Stonebat, I should say. Stonebat's a very good player. You know, it's all the tools. It's a sweep. The jump in gets blocked. Cross up, it looks like. For a reset or something. And a Blanca ball. Cross up. And a Blanca ball. Flying bicycle. That's super. Yeah, they both got meter. Yeah. Stonebat's just a monster. Just wreaks havoc. Alright, opens up with a slap. Loken from the slap. But it seems like he dropped him in the special conference. But it doesn't matter because he's got a reset. He did death. What a sequence. Blanca ball. In the grab. Oh, yep. There you go. I don't know if he has like a hard input on the super in this game, but definitely a weird input, I probably. Hard to pull off the super grab. Uh-oh, that could be a ring out. Here we go. Scott meter. Anyone's game. Whoa, he's just going to party mode. Wow. Duck King install. Wild. Alright. There you go. Stonebout, master of all characters. Giving a performance again. I think he has a YouTube channel. Should check that out. Of course, check the Crazy Battle Circuit YouTube out as well. And the challenge. I think there's unclaimed. Is there any unclaimed challenge codes? Yeah, there's still some. So make sure to check out the challenge. Or Macharino. Sorry. Yeah, not to lunch. Macharino. My bad. Yeah, Yeah, I have a lot of I have a lot of trouble with SNK grab supers, but that deck can really pull it off, it seems. I mean, like, KOF grab supers are always pretty easy, but some of the Fatal Fury ones are kind of hard. Like, Yamazaki's 360 is sometimes just really hard for me for some reason. I can do, like, regular 360s in other games, but can't do Yamazaki's for some reason. All right, loading into Hoxnorth versus Warlock 360. Earlier we saw... Earlier we saw Hoxnorth's Mai played very well. Very good space control and zoning. Pretty good conference. I got booted, but I think they're in game. Trying to load in. Oh, alright, yeah, they're in match. Alright, so Kim's beating up Mai. Warlock is playing with Kim. Alright, cool. Lunge attack from Hoxnorth Mai in the corner. We've seen this before. Mai, an excellent character getting those ring outs. We'll see if he makes it happen. Regardless, plenty of chip damage. But Kim lands the super. Mai at low health in the corner. Looking for a reversal opportunity, but does not find it as he is reversed against by the flash kick. Very precarious. Ooh. And that dive kick gets stuffed out by that air to air. Interesting situation. Flash kick. Dive kick. Lunge attack getting hit. The air to air very well. Hold on. Lunge attack gets blocked. The punish. I wonder if you can punish it. My has meter. Go for the super. Getting hit by these flash kicks. Into the confirm. In the corner, where he wants him. But the flash kick whips. Grab will punish. There's the fireball. Break the wall. Uh-oh. Now you're in trouble. Yeah. Gets out of there. Doesn't want to be anywhere near that wall. But Maya's throwing her fireballs in three lanes at once. Hard to keep up with. It's a sweep. Reversal, bring fireballs, low health. Needs to find the super to take it for the time, not be on his side. Mai takes it. Final round, both players have meter. Blocks a jump in, but the reversal does a lot of damage. Tries to look for the low confirm, but doesn't have it. There's a major whiff on it. This is the confirm. Major whip on it again. Against the wall. Yeah, there we go. Let's see a combo. Break that wall. Escapes. Blocks the lunge damage. Double combo. Good punish. Tries to go for overhead, but a little bit too late. Punish. Where he's playing neutral. Looking for opportunity. Pokes back and forth. Very low life. Very close. Could be anything. Everyone's looking for something. And Mai finds it. With a stray poke. Takes the game. Plus one for Hoxnorth. Stops her going for the fireball. Wow, lots of strong hands. Air to airs. The flash kick takes it. Tries to use step kick pressure, but gets blown up by a fat combo. And gets blown up by a flash kick. It's pokes, going back to neutral. Waiting out, looking for confirm. Doesn't find it. That's going to be a punish. but not much damage. Big combo in the corner, throwing fireballs. We'll clear some meter. Low health. Anything could take it right now. One combo either side. Last kick whiffs, but the punish isn't there. So much panic. So close. So close. That was crazy. Ramble. Alright. Back to zoning. Doing a great job at keep out against the Kim. Box lunge attack, and we'll see a good punish combo ending a knockdown. But there's another block. Where's the punish opportunity? It's gonna be hard. Both players still have meter. That's a lot of chip, and the wall just broke. Mai is still low life, though. Doesn't have the meter anymore. Doesn't have to do a ring out, and that's a little happen. Oxler takes it. Sure. Wow. Very good pressure. Lots of ring outs. That's definitely been the main consistency with this Mai. Lots of ring outs. Looks like I'll be getting into my next match. I'll be having... I'll get to have some front combo practice. Really annoying not having low snake armor. safe. Come get me. Oh, thank God. Come get me. Come on. Wow. Alright, GG's. Well played. Well played, Toro. Yeah, I'm done with playing Yamazaki in this game. I don't think I'm ever gonna play Yamazaki again in this game. I think from now on, I'm just gonna play I don't know. I need to find someone else now. Is the stream popping off? Stream lagging? Oh. I don't know how to play Yamazaki in this game. I guess I just thought it would be more like two. But this is, like, really different. Yeah, so now we're waiting on our next match, I think. Am I missing something? Are they playing? Oh, the verses, right? There we go. Our next match. Reacher 28 versus Sprite and Bananas. I believe Reacher 28 played Kim? I don't remember. One of these people played Kim. Waiting for them to go in game. Like they're heading off. Eight versus Sprite and Bananas. So we got Billy Kane, Terry Bogard. Lots of back and forth going on. I guess Billy isn't finding many opportunities. The pressure is pretty strong. It's chipped out. Here's a 28, takes round one. Ooh. If you have the Mater, might as well spend it. Whoa! I don't know which side blocked that one on. There's a meter. There is him in the corner. Billy's looking for opportunity. Doesn't find it. Probably, maybe could have had a punish, but needs to get Terry out of the wall. Because definitely isn't going to find a way to put the damage in there. Time. So really, unless Billy finds a way to position himself, Darius is gonna cleanly take him out. That was good, really good exchange for Billy. Reversal. There he has the meter. Crack shoot. And push him towards the wall. That won't happen as Billy gets the reversal round. Bring out the cane. Don't call him Billy Kane for nothing. And a side switch attack. Bucks. Blocking the crack shoot. Gets hit by the sweep. Players looking for opportunity. Pressing buttons. Looking for confirms. Doing block strings. Oh, he gets hit by the jump around. Crack shoot. In the corner. Ground wave. Ooh. Step kick away from the wall. Tries to parry, I Crack shoot. Gets hit by the sweep. There he takes it. There he has meter. And so does Billy. Ooh, that was a power game. Now wave. In the wall. Does him right at the wall. Blocks the... Down wave pressure. A lot of pressure. It's hard for Billy Kane to do anything with this. Needs to attack, but there's such a good defense, it's difficult. Harry takes the game. Well played, Spite and Bananas. All right, and we have Camion versus Warlock 360. Yeah, Toro's gonna stick with that Cameron's got. Is this a button check? No input from Warlock? Alright. So Cameron most definitely gonna play Kim. Thank you.
Thank you. だまだ。
100年早いんだよ。
日本一。 2.